Hi, I'm Brian Sullivan. I'm a senior security researcher with Adobe Systems, and I'm here today with Michael Howard from Microsoft. And we'll be talking about principles of attack surface analysis and reduction. So probably the best place to start with this is just to say, you know, what is attack surface? What do we mean by this? And a great way to introduce you to this is just to think about a real world analogy. And the analogy that I like to use is a car. I got a new car recently, and I got all the bells and whistles on it. I readily admit I'm a total gadget guy. But of all the little perks I got with the car, by far my favorite is the GPS. It's a fantastic feature. If I'm lost or whatever, I can just press a single button, it'll take me home. Or if I'm running low on gas, it'll point me to the nearest gas station. So these are really cool features. It adds a lot to the value of the car for me. But it also adds a lot of attack surface. Like, what would happen if I was out and a thief stole my car? Well, now not only does he has my car, but he can use that GPS the same way I did. He can press that button, and it'll take him right to my house. And he knows I'm not there because I was out in my car. And he can even use the automatic garage door opener in the car to let himself in my house. So while this was a great feature, it also added a lot of danger for me. And this, of course, has analogs back to the software development world as well. All our users love new features. This is what sells products. This is what gets people really excited about using software. But all of these things do come with a potential cost in terms of attack surface. Now, I'm not saying that we're all going to have to go back to